shop right now and I'm listening to The Verve, you know, their album, which was, I don't know how we say, Urban Hymns or Urban Hymns. You know, the first song was very famous. It was a Bittersweet Symphony. And I was doing a comparison with Talk Talk, though there is no comparison to do because it's completely different. The only common point I would say is that they are both British, that they both have a kind of psychedelic feeling sometimes in their songs. But I was making a comparison about the way of composing between the both. However, the song that we just heard before obviously was made around arrangements and there was no melody at all. I don't say that all the Verve songs are like that. Some of the songs are really good with a good melody, but I'm not sure that they put the same quality in their composition as Talk Talk. So right now I'm trying to figure out which song of the Verve was written by starting from the arrangements and which ones were really composed like a melody. So for example, this is a song which was written with the melody at the beginning. You will see. Very nice melody, very Beatles-like, I would say. So British, so British. And listen to that. It sounds like U2, you know? So you see, very nice melody, composed really in the, like a feeling of Beatles with a little of U2 in it. That is something that we remember because the melody was there and the arrangement came just behind, but the arrangements are very simple. They don't need to do a lot because the melody is already there. Now you will see the next one. So listen to that. There is a gimmick at the beginning. I think that started with that. So it's from the arrangements. That is not a melody. This is a gimmick made by an instrument. That is not a melody. That is something they stuck on the arrangements. They had the gimmick, they had the rhythm. They started from the arrangements, really. There was not a melody. They just put the melody they found on the arrangements, like to fill the blank, you know. That's what I see, the difference there is between the both, you know. Many groups, they consider that they had to do a few very good songs for the side one or the side A, and they didn't need to do good songs for the side B. But with Talk Talk, all the songs are good. A and B, the B sides are absolutely incredible. They could be A sides. I will show you. Listen to that. That is John Cope. This is a B-side. For me, it's the essence of what I call pop music, but not by a negative way. For me, pop music was pop music like when I was a child. For me, pop music was psychedelic music. And probably, maybe I was wrong with this meaning, maybe I didn't understand well what was pop music when I was a child. But for me, this is the essence, the core of the pop music in the sense psychedelic music. And this is not a B-side, it's an A-side. So the arrangements are good also because they wanted to give a feeling in this song, an ambiance that we really can feel. I see so many images on this song. It will be a painting also, for sure. There are melodies everywhere, in the arrangement and in the voice too. I love it. Again. That was the B-side of... The B-side of Such a Shame. Of course, it's not as strong as Such a Shame. but that is not a B-side. This, Without You, B-side of Dumb Dumb Girl. Seriously, B-side? That is a A-side. Stop acting like this. That is a... I love this song. I could listen to it the whole day. And this, It's Getting Late in the Evening. It was the B-side of Life's What You Make It. Seriously? The B-side? This is one of the most beautiful songs I ever heard. And the melody is so wonderful. My Foolish Friend is probably one of the most strong melody, but it's not a B-side, it's an A-side, and it was a single, it's not even in the album. It's an excellent melody, a wonderful melody, and obviously they started from the melody and they made the arrangement after. But you see, that is Colin the Night Boy. It was the B-side of My Foolish Friend, if I don't make a mistake. Listen to this melody. That is the best proof of what I'm saying. Just a voice and a piano, and that's it. And you have your song. You don't need arrangements, you don't need anything. You have the melody. And the piano is just there behind to go along with the melody. But as you can see, we barely hear the piano, just the melody. It's the voice, it's the song. It's wonderful. It's like if he's talking and singing in the same time, but there is a true melody. I don't care what people say.
I don't care what people say.
The original version is on the CD, on the album It's My Life. It's not just voice and piano, there is really arrangements, but that is the proof that we don't need arrangements, we just have the song and the voice and the lyrics, and that makes a song, that's how we make a song. I like how they started the next song. Just after that, we think that it's the follow-up of this song, but no, it's another song. Why is it so hard? Excellent song as well, you know. There is a true melody too. It's very difficult for me sometimes to sing the Tok Tok song because it's all too high or all too low for me. But of course, I'm not a man. Is it so hard? Yes, why is it so hard? That is a question I have in mind every day.